You want my advice?
Please.
Stop trying to be like the other rookies, because you're not. Jackson is 20 years from having his first colonoscopy, and Lucy has never even owned a pet, let alone raised a kid. You're a grown man, fully formed. So stop treating it like it's a liability and treat it like what it is, a strength. Sure, you can be annoying, and you talk way too damn much. But you also listen to people's troubles, to their complaints. And that type of empathy can't be taught, only earned. So if you really want to make detective, the only way to do it is to be you.
It's not easy, though, trying to keep up with these 20-somethings. Sheesh. Every day, I am determined to beat them, and every night, I'll crawl into bed feeling beaten.
Can I offer you some hard-won advice?
Please.
You are never going to beat them at being 20-something. But what you lack in flexibility or the ability to run up a flight of stairs without getting winded, you more than make up for in life experience. And that puts you way ahead of the curve day one of a job.
I have to find him.
Welcome to the arrest.
I got him.
You sure you don't want me to drive?
Why would I want that, Boot? You think I'd go back on duty before I'm 100%?
No, sir.
Or you think simply doing your job during a firefight means you get special treatment?
No, sir.
You'll drive when you've earned it. That work out the way you planned it, Boot?
Have you let me drive?
I'm not here, Boot.
Right, of course. Sorry.
You're driving today, Boot.
What?
You heard me.
Why?
Look, if you don't want to.
No. I do. What's the catch?
Why does there have to be a catch?
There's always a catch.
Not today.
That poor kid. Imagine having that idiot as your father.
Guy's just clueless. There are a lot worse out there. Trust me. I'm living proof that some people should not be parents.
You think you'll ever have kids?
Honestly, I thought I would have had some by now. Isabel and I, we made all these plans, pop out 3 kids, watch them grow up, have kids of their own, but
things don't always work out, which is why you think I should make contingency plans.
Watch out! Control 7 out of 100, possible 5150, Olympic ad citrus. Male 30 is now attacking my shop. Get an additional unit in an RA, code 3. 7-9-100, suspect vehicle heading west on Vernon. Shows in pursuit.
Thank you.
We need to stop this guy.
That's not a minivan, it's a mini tank. Bulletproof, bomb-proof. Our shops can't hit maneuver it. We have to wait for the bear gap.
Maybe we can box the Humvee in, force him off the road.
There's one way we can find out.
Okay, Nolan, get on his left. We'll take the right. You have to ram him in unison, right? Aim for the doors. Whatever you do, don't hit the wheels.
What? Why? What happens if I hit his wheels?
We'll die. And you'll forever be known as an LAPD cautionary tale.
Oh, great. Proving my mother right once and for all. Wait, I'll be the cautionary tale? No way. If this goes bad, we will both be disgraced together.
In position.
All right, on three. 1, 2, 3!
Did you?
I didn't have time. I gotta find a new place to live.
No excuse, Boot. Napping is the key to midnight shift. No shorter than 20 minutes, no longer than 40. But hey, if you're comfortable ignoring my institutional wisdom.
Ha ha ha!
Captain Jen.
No. No.
Wow.
FBI doesn't really do moderation, do they?
Seriously, it's like a spaceship.
You get any sleep?
No, but Sleeping Beauty here got an hour in the back of the shop.
Sergeant Stripes come with privileges. Don't be jealous.
Okay, people, listen.
What happened? You had a fiance in San Diego, a job lined up through Wounded Warriors?
What can I say? I moved on.
You tell me what I'm being charged with?
Resisting arrest for starters. The rest is up to the DA.
Right, and how exactly did the cops end up in my hotel room?
She can't tell you that.
Huh? But you can.
I can't. Be in violation of the victim's privacy.
Victim? What happened to Joe? Is Joe all right?
I've already said too much.
Is he dead?
Detectives will come speak with you shortly. Mitch, inside.
He doesn't seem to like you very much.
I'm the reason he lost his leg.
What do you know about a nervo?
Nothing.
Bull, what does it mean?
It means you just nuked me.
It's a little dramatic, don't you think?
No. He called me at work, and I would bet money that somebody used the e-name on an unsecured cell phone where it was captured by an NSA keyword program that triggered an immediate tactical response. Hell, there's probably a Predator drone up there right now.
Kate, it...
Damn it!
I thought I had to become someone else to do this job, that who I was before wasn't good enough. I was wrong. I earned my place here. And I'm not leaving.
You know why I do this job, Officer Nolan?
Because you're a people person?
No. This job is my calling. And I have a responsibility to protect it from those who are unworthy.
I understand.
Good. Then understand I will haze, harass, and humiliate you every chance I get. In the hope that you choose to abandon this misguided quest.
And if this job actually is my calling,
then nothing I do to you will matter.
You are the worst new agent trainee in the history of the Bureau.
Yes, sir.
You're unconventional, you're stubborn, and you possess an almost pathological inability to follow protocol.
Yes, sir. But I did help catch a terrorist, a rogue CIA agent, and his evil-ass hit squad, so it should kind of balance itself out, right?
This time.
Thank you, sir. And it was an honor to work for you.
I'll be keeping tabs on you. I mean, I'm not going to put my thumb on the scale with the Academy, but if you do manage to make it through, who knows? Maybe you'll come work for me again.
Hmm? In your new unit?
My... Loose lips, Agent Fox?
Yes. Sir, sorry, sir.
You can't really blame her. Kind of hard to resist. See you in a couple months.